أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته My dear friend and brother and sister في الله I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept your soul and I'm sure you are a bit exhausted at the same time you are regretting that Ramadan is finished And you're already looking forward to the next Ramadan, and it is like you have said farewell to a very close friend. And in reality, Ramadan is not finished. The message of Ramadan, you are reflecting it. You are a reflection of Ramadan. And the very proof that you shouldn't be sad that Ramadan is finished is that Allah made it haram upon you to eat or to fast today. And one of the proofs that you should rejoice with the fact that Ramadan is finished is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made fasting forbidden for you today. He wants you to praise Him, He wants you to gather, He wants you to pray, and He wants you to eat and to be grateful. So now, barakallahu feekum, a Muslim is not someone who misses something. A Muslim is not someone who thinks that he or she is in need of a certain place, person, or situation in order to find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because worship for him or her goes far beyond a place. It goes far beyond a space. It goes far beyond anything which he sees or she sees or knows. Because it is being connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in everything you do. So your first thing now is be happy with the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed you to go through this school which is called Ramadan and that today he ordered you to eat and to rejoice. But then again, like Shawaal, you are taking the last part, yani with your last energy which remains in your body after this long fast, you are now going to try to give 6 more days of yourself during Shawaal. These 6 days, they don't have to be consecutive. You can fast them now and then in 2 days again, or you do it on Monday and Thursday, whatever you like. They are not obligatory. You are not a bad Muslim if you don't do them. But if you do them, then you will be rewarded immensely by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if this is telling us something, if this is teaching us something, it is whenever you think you are out of gas, there is more. Whenever you think that you are out of energy, there is more. Why is there more? Because your journey and your struggle doesn't end until the last breath leaves your body. This is what Shawaal is telling us. People saying, wow, that was a difficult soum. Well, there is more. Whenever you think there is less, there is more. And in this way, the Muslim keeps on battling his ego and his self until he finds Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah will pick you up when you fall, but and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will strengthen you whenever you feel weak, but you need to keep on going. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَاعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ يعني, and worship your Lord until death comes to you. This is why Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah azawajal, when he was asked, like, when will you finally rest? He said, when I am with my both feet in paradise. Until we die, we don't give up. Like the Prophet ﷺ didn't like people to give up. He said, if you were to know what the reward was for praying, if you knew what the reward was for praying in the first row and for making the call to prayer, then you would have come even if you were to have to crawl for it. So the Prophet ﷺ said that if you would know the real reward for praying in the first row in the mosque, you would crawl to the mosque, meaning that even if you would have to crawl, you would do it. And this is why the Prophet ﷺ said to Ibn Maktum, and he said, Ya Rasulallah, should I come to the mosque? Because I have nobody to guide me. He said, do you hear the adhan? He said, yes. He said, then ajib. Yani then give answer the call and come to the mosque. Why? Because we never give up. Whenever we can't, we can. This is the school of Shawaal. And like this, we will always do like, and that's the same thing when you return from your job. Whenever you return from work at night and you had a very difficult day, then very often your prayers will be shorter. Yeah, I mean not like 4 raka'at will turn into 2. I mean you will read a bit quicker, your sujood will not be as long as usual. Well, you should do exactly the opposite. Because behind these efforts, you will find Allah. People found Allah behind the door of exhaustion. People found Allah behind the door of fatigue. People found Allah behind the door of despair. People found Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala behind all of these things. And the majority of people who look for Allah do not want to leave their comfort zone, and that is why they don't find Him. But now Shawwal is telling us, well, get out of that comfort zone and don't just say, Ramadan is finished and I'm okay. No, you will now take your life into your hands and you will climb. You will keep on climbing until you found what you were looking for, and that's the nearness of Allah Jalla wa Ala. So Shawwal is, that's cool. It is in everything like this. So barakallahu feekum, take away from this month. One, if you can't, you can. If you can't, you can. Two, worship Allah until your last breath. Three, never give up until you are with your both feet in paradise. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه والحمد لله رب العالمين.